All foreign people watching this, y'all need to hear this right now. Because I feel like foreign people only have kids in order for them to make them come up. They think that one of these 10 kids that they have that they know damn well they can't afford is eventually going to be the next Oprah Winfrey and they're going to have it made. That is not how life is supposed to go. If you want to do things to contribute to your household, you should and you can if you want. You should never be forced. Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. Today we are going to be doing a broke kid survival guide. Now this is a spin off of my previous real talk video about how to survive a toxic household, and you guys told me you wanted to know how to survive a broke household. So if you guys do not know much about me, hey, what's good? My name's Ivana. All my personal information can always be found in the description box. You guys always ask me, like, what's my name? What's this? What's that? And I'm like, bro, all in the description box below. And I am from Elizabeth, New Jersey, currently residing in Newark. I am of Haitian descent, and I do not come from money whatsoever. This video is not for the broke and flashy. If you broke as fuck, but you wanna wear True Religion and shit like that, this is not for you. It's for people that actually care about creating generational wealth and actually don't want to be the next broke parents with their kids who are gonna be watching this video 10, 15, 20 years from now. My parents had money once upon a time. They were out here, okay, at one point. Right before I got into high school, shit really started to go downhill. I started off in private school and later on put myself in public school when I went on to high school because I knew my parents simply couldn't afford it. This really hurt them because I guess they realized that I understood that we were not financially capable. But to be honest, it was the best decision I ever made, even though I got into numerous fights and numerous problems. I do not regret going to public school. And honestly, high school has made me who I am today. I love my high school dearly. I still talk to a lot of the teachers. And it's just always been an incredible experience. Like, if I was to ever become a millionaire, Johnny Dwyer Technology Academy in Elizabeth, New Jersey, getting all my bread, okay? Like, they would get so much money from me because, like, I love that school so much. In a standard home where your parents are financially capable, you grow up with a trust fund, you grow up with a savings account, you grow up with some type of financial means. You get a car when you're 16. You end up having some type of thing set up for you when you are 18, when you go to college. Your parents offer to pay for you, etc. But I didn't really have any of that. So essentially, I am a self-made person. My parents did not get me a car. I bought my own car twice. My parents did not really help me throughout school the entire time. They helped me the first semester, but other than that, I was on my own for the rest of the 4 years. I grinded my way to where I am today. And I'm very, very proud of myself. So I am living proof that you can genuinely be who you want to be, when you want to be, how you want to be, as long as you put your mind to it and you do not let your current circumstances stop you. So understand that, yes, I know that some people become broke later on because that's what happened to my parents. And I definitely do understand that some people just don't end up in the best circumstances and are very pro-life, so they are forced to keep a child. And I do understand that certain things like addiction and immigration and stuff like that can cause people to be very low in the economic ladder. So that brings me to my first point, okay? If you are already broke, do not go and put yourself in complicated situations, okay? Do not go out having kids knowing damn well you can't even pay your phone bill. Don't go out and buy a car knowing damn well you can't afford the car note. Don't go out trying to date a girl that you know love Louis Vuitton, you feel me? If you know you ain't got money, stay in your ain't got money lane and focus on what is going to get you out of that rut. Now, I know there's a lot of people that will tell you to save, save, save. I would say that, but you can't really save yourself out of poverty, but you can stop yourself from buying shit that's just ridiculously unnecessary. Like, you should not be sitting there eating DoorDash and Uber Eats every day knowing damn well that you got bills to pay. You shouldn't be out here going out to concerts when you know you got credit card debt. You should not be out here trying to buy clothes at Banana Republic when you on a 4 mile meals budget, you feel me? At the end of the day, it's all about living within your means and actually paying down whatever debt you have. So if you do have any debt, that brings me to my next point.
That is your debt. Do not pay anyone else's debt. I know a lot of you guys watching this are probably forced into situations where you have to pay your parents' stuff or you have to do certain things in the household. If you're gonna do things in the household, make sure that you're doing it because you live there. Don't be sitting there living like across the fucking country and you're sitting there sending people money to pay their bills and you can't pay your own bills. Or you're living in a household and you know you have things to pay, you have college applications, okay, you don't have a job or whatever, but people sitting there every day asking you for money. That is not okay. At the end of the day, you are a child and you should be able to be the child. It is not your responsibility to do things for other people. It is not your responsibility to take care of your parents. And I know all the foreign people watching this, y'all need to hear this right now. Because I feel like foreign people only have kids in order for them to make a fucking come up. They think that one of these 10 kids that they have that they know damn well they can't afford is eventually going to be the next motherfucking Oprah Winfrey and they're going to have it made. That is not how life is supposed to go. If you want to do things to contribute to your household, you should and you can if you want. You should never be forced. You should never be forced. You should never be forced to do any of those things. You should want to do that out of the kindness of your heart, but if you can't, then don't. You have to put yourself first. Establish a plan. Establish some goals. Make sure you execute them. Like, I had got to a point where my parents ran up a light bill to like $3,000 and the electricity bill was $2,000 and I had just received my first YouTube check. And it was about maybe $6,000. Well, it was my first check. It was my first, one of my bigger checks at the time. It was like $5,000, $6,000. I had the money to pay everything off. And you know what I did? I moved out because I have constantly bailed them out of situations. Not only that, they sat there and they didn't tell me anything. I didn't know any of this was happening until boom, I'm trying to film a video. All of a sudden, the lights ain't on, you feel me? And I've talked about this numerous times in my videos. Now, I did help them, you know, pay it later on once I moved out and stuff like that. But the point I'm trying to get at is I put myself first. I got myself right so I can help them. You can't help other people when you ain't got shit yourself. You can't go and provide aid when you are in just of a bad situation. Like, it's just, it doesn't make sense. And I know that parents like to make it feel like you owe them, but you really don't. You don't owe anyone anything. You should, and if you can, that's great. But if you can't, don't stress yourself. Like I said, make a plan, okay? Are you going to go to school? Are you gonna go to trade school? Are you going to get a job and move up through the ranks? Are you gonna go to the police academy? Are you gonna go to the military? Are you gonna be a stripper? Like, you need to think of a plan because at the end of the day, ain't no one gonna help you but you. You can sit there and wake up, eat, shit, shower, go to school, go to work, come back, repeat, and do absolutely nothing. But understand, you did absolutely nothing and that's your fault. Your circumstances aren't your fault, but your actions following the circumstances are always your fault. The way you react to things is what's going to determine how you succeed in the future. You can be as broke as hell and become the next Oprah Winfrey if you work hard at it and you have a solid plan. Do not just sit there in your situation, wallow in sadness, be mad, pick up drugs, pick up bad habits, bad people, bad peen, and bad cuckoo, okay? And think that's gonna solve your issues. Getting high is not gonna make your problems go away. Being mad is not gonna make your problems go away. Blaming people is not gonna make your problems go away. You're gonna make your problems go away. You don't have to go to college, but you have to have something more than a high school diploma. And if you didn't graduate from high school, you have to have a high school diploma. There's no ins, ifs, or buts about that. I understand people wanna be on this new age wave of, oh, well, the education, this, education, that. Yes, the education system in the United States is fucking disgusting. It's garbage, it's trash. I say it all the time, but you still need it to go somewhere. If you wanna make change, you have to follow through protocol in order to make the change where you want the change to be. So with that being said, you have to find a way to educate yourself so you are open to more opportunities to make more money so you can help you and eventually your family in the long run. Having no money definitely does force you to grow up. You end up having to buy things for yourself. You end up having to possibly take care of younger siblings. You end up having to even pay some bills if need be or whatever the case may be. And that really sucks and has a definite heavy toll on your mental health. So I definitely advise any of you who lives in a broke household, get psychological help. And I really wish I did get help when I knew something was wrong because all of this fucked me up. Like, it's to the point where I'm 25, I have my own spot for the past 3 years. I pay my bills on time all of the time. And I'll still come home afraid that I'm gonna have an eviction notice on my door. Like, I'll still come home and flicker on the lights on and off to make sure that I did pay the light bill, even though I know I paid the light bill, you feel me? Like, I've become kind of paranoid, and there's times where I have flashbacks to sleeping in hotels or staying with family who didn't want me there and would say shit about me while I was there. I have flashbacks. You know, I think about certain things that I shouldn't think about, and I wish I would have got help before. And even to this day, there's certain things I just don't talk about, you feel me? So it's important to have a professional there to address these feelings so you can get through them instead of burying them. If you can't get to a therapist or you're not ready yet, try to immerse yourself into manifestation. Yes, I know you guys probably hate that word. Honestly, I'm tired of it too. I feel like when people learn a word, they don't know how to stop using it, okay? But yeah, manifestation. If you have dreams, if you have goals, honestly, think about them every day. Immerse yourself in them. Don't just write it down in your notes. Don't just think about it in your dreams. Actually immerse yourself in it. Instead of saying, I can or I want, start saying, I will. Instead of saying, oh damn, like, I really think I want to become a dancer. Why don't you set up those auditions to be a dancer? Instead of sitting there saying, damn, like, I really want to be a lawyer. Why don't you look up how you could go to law school with a scholarship? You feel me? Like, you need to really start immersing yourself in your plans and manifesting what it is that you want with action behind it. It's not enough to just daydream about it or write it down or put it on your damn vision board. You have to put steps and actions towards all these things at all times. If you get an allowance, save it, okay? Save it. Don't waste it on bullshit. If you're gonna waste it on bullshit, put half of it away and spend the rest on bullshit. But do not, okay, do not waste any of your allowance money on BS. If you are old enough to get a job, get a fucking job to support yourself. If you do have to support your family, make sure you put money away for yourself as well. And I know a lot of people, especially if you're a parent watching this, you might feel upset. But don't tell anyone how much you make, because if you give anyone in your family or anyone a portion of money, or they're expecting a portion of money from you, they're gonna be like, oh, why you only give me 100 when I know you made 350 this week? Give whatever it is you gotta give and save it away. I would say don't give anything at all, because you have to worry about yourself. Try to help your parents find a better job. Now, this is something I did, and I was very successful at. Oh my God, hold up. Clap it up for me. I did it twice. I found my dad a couple jobs. I found my mom her current job for the most part. So yeah, like, if you really think that your parents should just be making more money and it would probably fix the issues, definitely try to help them find a new job. If they're immigrants, it's definitely a lot harder, but it's definitely possible, because I've done it a few times. So that's something you can do if you don't want their finances dipping into your finances. But make sure, if you are gonna find them a job, that it's something that, one, they can do, two, they can get to, and three, that they are gonna be happy at and stay at, or at least content with, because you don't want them just jumping in and out of jobs and stuff like that. Like, if you know that they can do the job, then go for it. But if you have any type of second guesses, just don't even do it. Start couponing. Now, couponing is a lot of work, but if you're a kid and you have nothing to do, like nothing to do, you live in one of them damn rural ass towns where ain't nothing going on, you ain't got no friends. Couponing. I can watch Extreme Couponing. Y'all know that. If you don't know that show, go watch it. It is incredible. There's people getting like $700, $900 worth of groceries for like 10 cents. Like, okay, not 10 cents, like $10. But that's still a massive saving. You get the point. If you coupon, you can get so many things for free, if not a discounted price. But it does take a fair amount of time. That's why I said, if you have a lot of time on your hands, it's perfect. But if not, you can also download those cashback apps and plugins, like, you know, Honeypot, Ibotta, Rakuten, like those type of apps, because every time you buy something at a certain place, they will literally give you a little bit of the money back. And trust me, you guys are probably like, but that's only a couple of dollars, only a couple of cents. Kid you not, it adds up and it will definitely come in handy. A lot of people may have too much pride for this, but try to find local food and local clothing banks. Now, yeah, this is, you know, some people just really don't have the pride to do it, but if it's free, fuck it, okay? If you have access to it, go get it. If you really need it, it's super great. There's a lot of food banks that offer really good food, and it is free. So it's like, why not just go and get it? It can definitely help you out. for a short amount of time or even a long-term amount of time. I know there's some food banks that give like shit, a lot, like weeks, even months worth of food, or depending on how many people's in your family, it can last you a long time. So definitely see if you have any local food banks or any like, you know, clothing banks if you need some extra clothes, because those can be super duper helpful. Focus on getting good grades. Now, a lot of you are like, how
the fuck am I supposed to concentrate when my parents are broke and they're fighting all the time and I hate my sister and my best friend's a bitch?
And yeah, I get it, I know. First world problems, right? Education is probably going to be your only way out. Not only, but the most straight and arrow, straightforward way out will be school. If you get good enough grades, you can get a really good scholarship. If you get a really good scholarship, you can go to school for free or a very, very minimal price just based off your grades. You can kick it up a notch by playing some sports and you really get picked up and you really out here, you feel me? Try to get good grades, get involved in school, because it will definitely help you in the long run. And especially if you go to school, you can easily stay on campus and get away from your family, not put as much, you know, financial strain on them or yourself because you'll be in school. You might incur a lot of debt, because I did, because I didn't have that many scholarships, but I did have a good amount of scholarships, to be honest. But like, I still do have a lot of debt from college, but still, it's not something that's like hindering me. I do pay it off, it is what it is. But it's like, I feel like we're all gonna incur some type of debt in the long run, so it is what it is. I feel like an investment in education is very important, and knowledge is very important as well. And it is the fastest short-term option, and will buy you some time to, one, get an education, two, find a really good paying job after graduation, and you know, three, be able to, for you to get your own place at the end and help your parents when you get out. And you know, that's what a lot of people actually do. I think that's what that's what I did, but I actually went back home. So my story is a little bit different. Having fun is so hard when you're broke. If you have friends that know damn well you broke as fuck, you ain't got no job, your mom and your dad don't give you no money, nothing like that, and they sitting there trying to go to movies every week, they trying to shop at Forever 21 every day, they sitting here trying to buy milkshakes every fucking day after school, those ain't your fucking friends. Stop wasting your money on bullshit, okay? I understand you want to do teenage shit, but stick to free shit. Go to the park, go to the rec center, okay? Join a damn sport. Cause you know, join a sport, join a club, they be having free food and snacks and shit. Riverfront, have a sleepover, free shit. Free shit. Parties, they got free food, free shit. Stop doing shit that's bleeding you money. And I know it's hard to think about this as a kid, but I'm telling you right now, if you get this right now as a kid or while you're younger, it's gonna save you so much money. And 5 years from now, you're gonna be looking back at this video, you're gonna be coming in my DM like, oh my God, the Mademoiselle, I'm so happy I listened to you. I know we all want to be flea or whatever, get the girls looking at you, make the boys look at your little apple bottom jeans, boots with the fur, like, nah, that is so old. Wow, I just showed my age right now. Don't do it. Honestly, never ever in your life spend more than $50 on one clothing item, and that's too much. I don't spend more than $20 on a clothing item unless it's really that popping or it's like for a very special occasion. Because one, you outgrow clothes and clothes go out of style. Two, they're too expensive for their fucking purpose. It's just clothes. And three, most of the time, a lot of people sit there and buy clothes to impress people that they don't even like. So what is the point? Stop thinking about impressing people you don't like. Stop trying to impress people who don't give a shit about you. Stop wasting your time, money, and energy on trying to please people who wouldn't even do the same for you. If your premise of, oh well, I need the new Jordans because all the kids gonna laugh at me, that's just not a good, it's not a good excuse, okay? It's just not. But I mean, I understand people wanna be bullied and all that extra shit, but I kid you not, guarantee you 100% when you get to be older, okay? As soon as you graduate high school, actually, you're gonna realize, why the hell did I waste all my time and money trying to impress these people? Like, I'm telling you right now, like, especially after high school, none of these people are even important anymore. None of these people are important. You don't even remember their damn last names anymore. You probably barely remember their first name. You only remember the impactful people. But even at that, your new Jordans, your $500 coat, or whatever the case may be, is not gonna impress them. They're gonna talk shit if they want to. At the end of the day, you should try to be preserving your money as much as possible. So definitely go to thrift stores, okay? If you really wanna kinda, I guess, outsmart people and make them think you got something, go to their store, but go when they're stocking. Yes, actually find out when they stock and go those days, because those are the times where they will have the best stuff and the newest stuff. It sounds crazy, but trust me, I bought in a whole Louis Vuitton bag and it was real from a thrift store and it was only $20, you feel me? So it's one of those things where like you have to have a good eye for shit, but on top of that, it will serve its purpose. But stick to the low end type of stores. I think this is hard if you're a guy though, cause y'all can't be walking out here with fake Air Force Ones and stuff like that. So I would say honestly, for me, I only splurge on shoes and bags. I don't spend money on clothes cause it's just not fucking, it's not necessary. I'm not buying, like, this is like a $10 shirt, right? Well, it came with pants. So I believe it was like a $10 set. So this is a $5 shirt with the $5 leggings. Like, I don't have time. It's just, it's unnecessary to spend all this money on clothes. Like, for what? As long as it looks good, it looks cute, and it fits, and it serves its purpose, which is to hide your privates, that's all that really matters. Stick to the Rainbow, the 10 Spot, the Fourmont Mills, the Walmart, the Target. Stick to H&M. Stick to the Forever 21 men, even though those are a little bit pricier, but at least you'll look good and it's good quality and no one's gonna clown you for having any of that on. So if anything, stick to those types of stores. Don't be out here trying to go to like Zara and Banana Republic and all. Just don't shop at your local strip, okay? If you want sneakers, go to Snipes, go to Magic Sneaker if you have one around you. I don't know, I think that's a local thing. You get the point, like go to more local places where things will be cheaper. Don't just go hop on the fucking Jordan site and order it from Jordan knowing damn well you can probably get it somewhere else for cheaper, you feel me? Like, it's just little things you can do here and there to save money, save you some grief, save your parents some grief, and actually elevate your lifestyle while you're waiting to create your own. It is very important to understand that a lot of times it's not your parents' fault that they're broke, okay? But I do not believe in people willingly having kids in poor economic circumstances ever. Well, in the United States anyway, I feel like in other countries it's different. But like, if you already know you can't afford your phone bill, why the fuck would you have a kid? Like, I just don't, it's just not okay. So if you do find yourself in those circumstances, trust me, you can and you will get out of it as long as you plan, as long as you get a higher education, it doesn't have to be college, and as long as you stay positive and get psychological help. Like, these are all the things that helped me. Comment down below if you're watching this and you have any advice for anyone watching. What is some advice that you have for those growing up in a broke household? Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.